I want to be looking for it in the game. I want to see it in the game. I want to see the quality.
Yeah.
All right. Nice.
One, two, three, four.
First of all, thanks for you coming today, coming to the Manchester Academy. Our home ground training every Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And this project has been started like 6 years ago. It's starting from this area here as well. This project work is helping the community, especially like 70% Somali community in the area, Moss Side, Rusholme and Falafel. And this project has been successful in supporting the dads and mom. I mean, all parents live in the area.
The logo stands for Whitworth Park Sports Club. Whitworth Park Sports Club is this park that we are in today. And in 2003, we decided to set up a football club in this area. And when we find out a group of young people who used to come to this particular park and play football, from there on, we realized that there was a lot of need for young people in this area. And at the time, there wasn't any clubs for junior football. Even till now, this is the main club or the only club that runs a junior football team.
I joined the club 3 years ago. The club's been running since 2007. And I was like, since 2009, 3 years.
What make you to join the club?
First of all, I had a friend of mine who is one of the club members, and we met at the league. He asked me to help out for the league. And one day I went with him, I looked the game and I watched it and I fell in love with the kids and the way they're helping the kids. So from there and then I decided to join the club and help out as much as I can.
They've just been doing the exercises, we've been working on the technical skills and we've been working on the awareness as well.
They have a match tomorrow.
There's a game tomorrow for these boys, yeah. So what we're doing, we've got to prepare them for the game. And we're not going to take too much out of them because they still need their energy. Clear, right where we pass, run on the blind side, hit the byline with speed. Yeah, I'll say all this again tomorrow. Yeah, but I want to be looking for it in the game. I want to see it in the game. I want to see the quality.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is that a deal?
Yes.
Abdi, you're the target man. And Addison. Anything outside the 18-yard box, I want you to take as the goalkeeper, yeah? The target man is going to be Ibi, yeah? This project has gone very, very well. I've only been involved maybe 18 months. But the introduction of the quality of footballers, young footballers from the community, has been absolutely excellent. The focus is to give the children focus. To keep drugs and guns off the streets and give them a focus, an outlet into sport. Listen to the goalkeeper. When he shouts out, you've got to push out together. Push out up to the halfway line.
Yes, it's my turn, yeah?
Yeah, it's your turn.
Abbas, come here.
It's your turn now.
What are you doing now?
We started training, so we did a session. The session today was four parts. This last part now is a game.
So
we divide the session four parts. So it's the last one now.
And this club is for the community in Moss Side, in here, Moss Side. And as you can see, it's club for everybody. You see a lot of kids. We coach and from 5-year-olds up to 14-year-olds. And we have 8 different teams that are competing in leagues in Manchester. And if you look around, you see under 7s, under 8, 9, 10, 11, and then later on there's another team is also coming up. So we cover from 5-year-olds up to 14-year-olds. And some of them have developed and went into a professional clubs. Some of them have even gone to the national team of England. And some kids who used to come and play. There's even some kids who are playing and for clubs like Wigan and with the junior level on the 18s, who are the part of the group we started in 2003.
Our aim is to help a young lad. It's not only football, but to educate. They have to have a good education. If you come in training here, you have to have a good education. You have to listen to your coach. So if you have to do your homework as well, sometimes my team here, if they don't do homework, if they don't listen to their dad, and their dad coming to me to complain, they go and get punt two game, too much, they can't play too much, or they can't come training the next week. So that's one discipline as well. So what we're thinking is have a good discipline and then they have a good footballer.
You don't tell him you.
My team, so come on. Yeah. Thomas,
come on. Ahmed,
go with Farah.
Now at home we could go like watch like much of the teams. We watch TV like England matches to see how they play, like how they pass to the wing and how they run down and shoot and cross it. And so we wanna be like them, like our best players are like Messi, Ronaldo, all of them. We wanna be like them. That's how we look at every single match they play, yeah, and see how they play. So we wanna be like them.
And we learn off their tactics.
And also our managers help us. They're very good managers.
What's your position?
My position is left wing striker. My number is number 11. I want to be like Ibrahimovic because he's good at heading the ball and he's also got shots. So if I want to be older, I want to be like Ibrahimovic.
What kind of impact has this project within the community?
Well, it's massive impact. The kids that we have, they all go to school. And after the school, some of them, they don't have nothing to do at home. They sit down. So what we do is we go back to the community. We ask the kids to, you know, come to play football. We show them what we can, what we do. And most of it, the players that we have, and when we had their, when they were like 7, 8, 9 years old, now when they become 12, 13, they're still with us. And they just don't go out to the streets, or they don't do something stuff bad. So they still, you know, I mean, that improves, you know, the change for the community and doing good things for the community as well.
Just recently, we've introduced some Somalia international under 16s. Because of the troubles over in Africa, in Mogadishu, they haven't been able to make a progress in this. And so what we introduced last year was to have a full international team with the backing from the KLMF League, and they played a friendly in Manchester against Manchester City, and it was very, very successful, and it got a lot of coverage. It's things like this that spread around the world from a small unit like what we have here, and development for children around the globe. People have been coming in from Sweden, Denmark, just to participate in our training sessions here.
Right, 1 second, we divide them, give them the big circle. Yellow. 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 Blue. 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 Ibrahim, blue. Get a blue from there.
On which way did this project, you know, direct or indirectly help the young lads here and the Mosa?
To be honest with you, it helped a lot in terms of when there isn't anything for them to do in this area. When there is not anything to do for, let's say, Friday night, a night like this, without this football, they would be on the streets, hanging around, and not able to do anything. So you can understand about 150 kids in here, and coming in, training different times, different age groups. If this football wasn't here, then it's pretty easy for the answer where they would be. They would be staying on the streets, and some of them would be, you know, getting up to things that are not good. And so it is really, 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 really important. And it's got a lot of impact in their lives.
I'm a rest now. We need a Casey.
Stop! Farah!
Stay the Reds. Who said you can?
Stick up!
Wichita Park, that means a sports club, it's not only concerning football, it's alive. We do athletic as well. I'm coach athletic. I used to be coach athletic as well. So we do Monday athletic, I took some kids from here to Manchester Arena. That's where the athletic activity goes. So we do athletic, we do basketball as well in Manchester Academy here. We do sometimes squash as well. We do the tennis table. It's not only football, but the football is a main. Last, we're thinking 80% of kids like the football. That's the reason why we give more time to football, but we do another activities as well.
Moss Side has got an history. It is a rich place in terms of history. It's a place that was always changing through decades. And there was generation who came here like 100 years ago. There was the African Caribbean community. Before that, there was the Irish community. And more recently, we have the Eastern African community, Somalians and all those communities. And just now, we're getting the Eastern European community arriving. So this place is rich with history. Always it welcomed new communities. And as you can see, no matter which parts of Moss Side you go, you will find people who is from different parts of the world. And it's a place that, for me, I would say Moss Side is a great example to the world.
Focus, focus. Keep going. Everybody, go. Back.